Hi. All right. So this is going to be a good one, okay? Because there is a number one mistake that almost all of us fall victim to when we try to get healthy. We start a new diet plan, meal plan. We try this, we try that, a fitness plan, a workout. We're going to do this for our exercise. We're going to do that. I'm going to put my shoes by the bed. And when I get up, like, we've got these different plans and we tend to start and stop them. And so the number one mistake is really holding us back. So I'm going to tell you what that is in just a moment. But most importantly, I want to give you three different tools to utilize to finally break the habit of this number one mistake. So knowing what the mistake is and then having these tools, I think is going to be a game changer. So I'm excited. This is actually inspired by a conversation I've been having with one of my clients over the last couple of days. And I was like, oh, I got to share this with you guys. So I hope you're excited. I hope you're ready. As you're popping on, say hello. I've got my personal page over here, my coaching page over here, and I really want to just see who's out there. So whether you're watching now, I want to give you a shout out live. If you watch later, just let me know, you know, hashtag replay, because I want to say hello later if you catch it later, okay? But so here's the thing. The number one mistake that we tend to make is we get a set plan and we're ready to follow it for a set amount of time. And so we get all geared up. We're going to go to the grocery store. Hello, Nicole. We're going to do all these things. And we're really focused. We like study the ins and outs maybe of what it is. Maybe somebody's helping you with a plan, or your friend did XYZ, or you get something from a package and you read the package, you read the whatever, right? Or you're going to start with a new fitness plan. And so you've got it all geared up. You're either going to have a personal trainer, or you've got your workout buddy in place, or you're going to start going to this class or join this gym, whatever it is. We start them, but how often do we start them and actually intend for that exact plan? So think of starting like a new fitness class, or think of starting a new meal plan, especially if it's a diet, because a diet tends to be very, very restrictive. And sometimes it has kind of some kooky rules. And so we're like, I'm going to do this. Like, so-and-so lost X amount of pounds because they did this for 2 months. So like, I'm going to do this for 2 months because I can't wait to see what happens for me in 2 months. So warning, side note to this conversation, never, ever, ever compare your results with what somebody else was able to accomplish or not accomplish, because we're all different. The reality is, if you're doing good things for yourself, good things are happening for yourself, even if you don't see it right away. But that's a sidebar. So the number one mistake, though, is that we start something, a new plan, and whether we actually put an end date on it or we just mentally know it, it's something that we're going to follow for a short or shorter amount of time. But we never look at it as, I'm going to start this plan. I guess I shouldn't say never, but especially, like I said, if it's a diet, it's a fitness class, it's whatever. We don't join it intending that that's going to be a part of our life forever in that exact manner. We jump in and we're like, well, I can sustain this for a short amount of time. I'm willing to do this and give up these things for a short amount of time. So what happens is, if you don't see the results, or even if you do, in a short amount of time, you pitch that plan, you go back to kind of feeling a little bit miserable, not feeling good in your clothes, not liking the image in the mirror, until the next time that you give it a whirl with a different plan or a different attitude behind the old plan or something like that. But it's always for the short amount of time. Okay, so I want to give you three tools on how to actually enter into the plan, not saying it's going to be exact for life, but knowing from this moment forward, my life's going to be different. Not I'm going to follow this until I lose my 20 pounds, but then I'm going to stop it and pretty much go back to normal. So if you do it right, first and foremost, you won't want the old normal because you'll be feeling fantastic and you'll develop habits. So what we want to do is, one, I actually did a whole live on this about a month ago, but one, change the mentality of the foods to saying I don't eat that versus I can't eat that, because that's just like gives you power. I got a hand on my head. They just walked in the door. All right, I'll be right with you. So change your can't. I'll look at how you play it in just a little bit. They just got back from the dentist and they got toys. So, but you're looking at I don't versus I can't. Okay, baby.
I have no cavities.
And then, yay, she has no cavities. Everybody give her a shout out for not having cavities. Some teeth emojis. Those are always fun. So then number two is one of the things where you can really start to catch yourself in this and get good at it, like this will stay with you for good and it'll start to spread to all areas of your life, which is awesome, okay? But so that it's start, every time there's like a cookie and you're like, oh, I can't, start switching it to I don't, right? Gives you power. I don't eat that because I'm choosing, right? Not a condemning. But start thinking about what you gain when you don't choose to eat that food, because it's really easy when your friends go out for drinks or they go out for some greasy appetizers or you're at the barbecue and everybody loads up their plate this big. It's really easy to feel like you're depriving yourself and you're having to restrict yourself because you can't have all the gooey ooey stuff. So first, you don't have it because you're choosing something better for yourself. But start thinking about, what does that create for you? What do you gain? Because you gain so much more, even if it's one more day of more confidence that you can do this. One more week of having a little less on the scale or a little more muscle mass. But most importantly, that's not going to stop you in that moment. What's it mean? Does it mean that if you create this habit and you get over that hump, because the beginning is always the hardest, or when you throw yourself off your rocker because of a vacation or something, it's the hardest getting back on. What does it mean for your future? What does it mean for you 5-10 years ago? What does it mean for your kids? Because you just decided to give up that one cookie. Like, it's really easy to go, well, one cookie in the scheme of things doesn't mean much, but I can't tell you how many daily reports I get of people giving themselves kudos because they went to the wedding and they decided it really wasn't worth having the cake. Yeah, they could have had the cake. Would it have messed up the whole scheme of things? No, but because they were able to make a powerful decision for themselves, now they have the confidence to make the next powerful decision and the next. Now, you know me if you've been following me. And if you haven't been following me, please put new, because I want to say hello to the brand newbies out there catching me for the first time. But you're also not allowed to guilt yourself, which I'm on a huge kick. You can have your cake and eat it too, kind of a thing. But when we make those powerful decisions for ourselves, it just means more powerful things. But when you do decide to have the cake or the cookie or whatever, you decided to make that choice, and that's okay too. Shaming yourself is only gonna put you in a negative spiral. So either decision, make it a powerful choice for you and move on, okay? So gain, what do you gain from making that healthy decision? So then step number three, I'm gonna say this. You guys are going to be like, that's great. It's an awesome idea, or I've heard it before and I keep meaning to do that. So if you're near a piece of paper, your planner, a thing you can write notes on the phone, send yourself a text to remind you to do this later. This one's going to change it. But I would say 1% of you are going to actually do it, even though it might take you 1 to 5 minutes to do and 30 seconds to do daily, okay? But this is your game changer, okay? Start changing your can'ts to don'ts. Start looking at what you gain, not what you lose, what you're missing out on. And number three, either write yourself a letter and or put out some goal clothing. Could be old stuff you don't fit into. It could be a picture of a dress you'd never in a million years see yourself wearing. but something, have something written. I wouldn't say and or. Have something written that you're going to review every day. Take only a brief amount of time if it needs to be. But write yourself a letter or jot down those reasons why you keep starting or why you started the exercise or the diet plan, the meal plan to begin with. Write it down why you're doing it. You can tie in the what you gain over what you lose, so it's top of mind. But write it down on a piece of paper. Put one on your office desk or one taped up on the wall next to your bed, one in your purse, run on the car that you see it every day, and start making a habit to at least once a day, like right when you wake up or right when you go to bed, but it'd be best if both, maybe on your lunch break, put it in your lunch bag, whatever. Actually review by physically reading it every day. It's got to be a daily reminder. That's why I said it'll take about 30 seconds to review, depending on how short it is, maybe even less. But it'll only take you a few minutes to actually do it, get it on paper, and put it in a few places. If you're at work right now, write it down, go to the copy machine and make a couple copies, or type it up and print it, right? But the daily reminder of why you keep starting, because when I ask you, you can kind of tell me in a roundabout way, but you kind of have to drum it up to top of mind. If you make it top of mind every single day, it's going to make it a whole lot easier to think of what you gain over what you lose and to change your can'ts to don'ts, because you're making a choice for you to live more powerfully in your greatness as somebody who succeeded at the goal that you keep trying to succeed at, okay? So in review, our number one mistake is that we look at these as diets with an expiration. So another fourth one would be never diet again. Diets don't work. The mentality change, okay, so this is cliche. This is cliche because it's overused. It's not a diet, it's a lifestyle. It's true, but we've all heard it so much, it's lost its meaning. So, but this is the idea, right? Is that you're creating habits that you can do forever. So if you are doing a plan like eating cabbage soup to lose weight, if it's not something you can see yourself doing 20, 40 years from now, depending on your age, more or less, right? Then it's not the right plan unless you're just trying to fit into a better dress a week from now and then you're going to be done. So those short-term plans can be great for the wedding, great for the one-time vacation, great for those, okay? But if you're doing this for permanent, then we've got to change permanently, and it starts with how you're thinking about it. So if you keep starting something where, well, I can do it for now, then it's not the right plan, okay? It's not the right plan. If you want to talk plans, let me know. We'll talk about your pros and cons of things you've done before. I can give you some guidance on maybe what plan you want to consider, okay? Feel free to message me or write down below that, hey, I want to talk, and we'll connect, okay? But first and foremost, you just got to know, like, yes, you're going to make it a lifestyle, but most of us have no clue how to do that or what that means, right? So it just means we're going to get a little bit better and we're going to grow in our skills a little bit more over time. I've been doing this healthy thing and lost the weight. Guys, I used to be plus size clothing. I'm down to a 2'4". Then I got pregnant. Then I got pregnant again. After both pregnancies, I lost the weight again. I've been maintaining the weight loss for 4 years since my last daughter. I keep, you know, maintaining and losing. So you can do that. And I'll tell you, I drank my beer. I enjoyed my brownies and my ice cream. Love pizza. I do all these things and I'm able to lose and maintain through it all. So again, it's not about just restricting yourself and saying I don't do that versus I can't do that to everything, but it's about creating that habit. It's about stretching that muscle that you really can. And it's about no longer doing the stupid little things. Sorry, I should say that nicer. No longer doing these things that promise all these major results by doing really drastic things, because that's not something you'll do forever, okay? So I hope that helps. I've got some shout outs to do here. my personal page always has so many people hanging out and watching, but they don't shout out and say hi. Say hi, guys. All right, but Audra's over here, Anne's over here. You know, guys, just remember that this is something that takes time. All of these habits aren't just like, oh, that was so great, I'm gonna go put it in place right now. You'll forget it again tomorrow. So maybe write these down. One more time, review. Number one, change your can'ts to don'ts. I don't eat that versus I can't. Change your mindset to what do I gain over what do I lose? Because it's really easy if you decide you're gonna get up early in the morning to work out to think about how you're losing sleep. But what are you gaining by actually doing it, okay? And a daily reminder, write yourself a letter or do some bullet points of why you're starting and why you continue to start, why you want to look and feel better. So it's not, I want to be healthy and I want to look good. Like, why? What's it going to change in your life? Okay. Those three things, write them down. Come back to this live if you need to and replay so you can write down the notes and make it top of mind until it becomes a habit. So I hope this helps. You guys have a beautiful, hello Monique and Vicky, hello. You guys have a beautiful and healthy day. And just remember, keep healthy simple. Mwah. Bye guys.